Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play The Sims 2 HC Baby Challenge Part 5. In the last part we got pregnant again with someone else's kid. I don't even remember his name. He is so irrelevant to my life. And our baby's also going to be aging up soon, so that's going to be pretty much the basis of this part. I do have to zoom off to work in an hour, and usually these episodes take me an hour and a half to film. So I am going to be doing most of the baby, the not dying when we're pregnant, off camera. And we're just going to jump back in whenever this baby's birthday starts. I don't know when that will be, but I don't want to, I want to make sure this is jam-packed full of content, but I also don't want to have to cut it off really abruptly to get ready for work. So today is Aiden's birthday. We are going to bring him to the cake. I'm really excited to have all our babies. I love Sims 2 babies. They're actually the super cutest. I hope he can reach the cake because I know the diagonals aren't really a thing that happens here. In fact, let me move it. Diagonals don't really work. Can't select. Okay, well it seems like he's going to it, so. Let's see our baby Aiden age up. Nope. Diagonals don't work. I'll move it over. Oh, let's not do that one. No. Bad. Okay, he needs to stop complaining about it. Oi. Okay, let's have this cute little birthday for my Aiden baby. I'm gonna try to have our kids as close together as possible. Like one after the other, after the other. Because I know she's not gonna have 26. She's already an adult. Like, oi. Young adulthood is not a thing here. She's gonna die so soon. There's my son. Aging up. Oh, stinky. We're gonna have to get our roommate to leave also. This is now a family house. Thank you very much. What is going on? Dog being taken from me? It's Aiden's birthday. Excuse me. Everybody in the world is in my house. This is just fantastic. This is so sad. But I would also really love for it to be done with. Bye. Oh, Maggie. Get out of my house. Who ate the cake? My son. I thought he was gonna put him in the fridge. I don't know. I need a new cake and I need everyone to leave my house, please. Good goodness. Bring Aiden to the cake. He's hungry, he's poopy. I just wanted him to eat the cake. Can you guys not in my house right now? Like, you wanna be friends somewhere else? That's cool. I'm trying to have a birthday for my son before my wife comes home. We need to redo his room. I need to kick out my roommate. I have so much to do today. He needs a shower. Oh my god. So much. And I just want him. But you guys are in my house fighting. Like, it's my son's birthday. Aww. Aiden, you look so cute. Oh, so cute. He's probably gonna. You know what? He has to stay downstairs. I don't want him to go upstairs. We have to kick out our roommate. Like, right now. In fact, I would love to move, but we don't have that kind of money right now. My roommate's at work. I guess I'm just gonna delete his bed. We'll see about later. Okay, our new baby's room is ready to go. We have no space. Like, as soon as she's pregnant with baby number 3, we gotta move. We got, let's, with our roommate being kicked out, I don't know where he's gonna sleep. We have no space unless the babies are moved upstairs permanently. I mean, I guess that could work. Like, they could have this room, but it'd probably be better if they did have this room. But we need the hot closet, and it's better if they're close to the they have their own bathroom right here. They're close to the fridge. He needs a bath really bad. It's just all a mess. We're gonna bathe Aiden. I hope our next baby's a girl. And they're just gonna share a room real quick. And we could just change Aiden. Let's change Aiden. And no cake. No cake for anybody. Change Aiden's diaper. Give Aiden a bottle. Like, let him live his life. He's so cute. Aiden's such a bean. And tell these people to get out. Also that. Everyone leave. You know, not everyone leave. Just Jason leave. Because you have no business being here, and just Toby leave. I don't want my maid to suddenly disappear. Because my house is disgusting. Get out. Like, look at them. Just touching my stuff, trying to use my violin. I don't even know why we have that. I don't have space for anything. And as soon as my roommate comes, I'm gonna be like, bye. Thanks. There's a cute rose outside. There you go, bebe. You're so cute. Yeah. Amelia doesn't even know that she's pregnant yet, which is an interesting thing. I also love how we cannot... I just have to throw away these cakes, $30 cakes. Is he upstairs in my house using my bubble blower? Get out. There's so much to clean up. So much to do, so much to clean up. She didn't even pick up that dirty bottle. At least my son is good. I love his little outfit, but I want him to go change. Oh. Oh, I have to change his outfit. Oops. Plan everyday outfit for Aiden. I'm very excited that I tried this science activity. That was a lot of fun. Oh, blocks. Yeah. He's so cute in his little outfit. I actually love it. Is he gonna be like super preppy? I could see it. Should base it off of what they choose to be in, like what their favorite colors are, what their style is. I forgot that we have to literally go buy clothes. So Aiden, enjoy it. Put Aiden down and we're gonna just clean up these bottles and go about our day, and hopefully Amelia will be home soon. Oh my god, we need a new puppy. Our dog died. I didn't throw any of her stuff because I was like, we're getting another dog soon. It's totally cool. I can't even reach this because of the dresser. There's no space. There's not a lick of space. And we probably are going to start looking at how much houses are and start saving for that amount. Because I'm gonna call a service, and we're also gonna look at real estate and purchase a vacation home. No, maybe a bigger apartment. Maybe I feel like that would be okay. We're gonna wait for Amelia to get home. Like, it's not even. We're gonna get our puppy though. Probably a puppy this time. What are you doing? In the dog bed. She died. Okay, let's see. I don't want to get an elder. I'd rather really get a puppy. Benny. Okay, there's like no girl puppies. Let's look at the tiny puppies. Boy, boy, girl, Susie, doofus, lazy, friendly, piggy. Oh, pig pen. I'd rather no pig pen, please. No pig pen. Finicky, hey, independent, genius. You're pretty good, Max. I'll take you. Yes, adopt Max. Our wife's gonna come home to an older baby, a dead dog. She's literally on her nightstand. She's dead. Maggie's dead. And we're miserable. I didn't even notice. Yeah, get your needs done. Poop. You need to take a nap. I mean, he can sleep there. It's not gonna hurt him. He's just sleeping. Poor baby. Poor baby. You also have to teach him all kinds of stuff, or we won't. Max is fine, or we won't get his, I just want a yard. But a new apartment would be fine. I don't know what I'm even talking about. I'm gonna skip to Amelia's home. Our puppy's here, but... Oh my gosh! So tiny! Yes, yes. Amelia's home! She's miserable, but she's very excited. She's ready to have another baby, and she knows it. And she's super tired. Oh, she's like gonna die. And I need little one on the way. Amelia's on maternity leave. Remember, the household has brought some new clothes. They need a dresser and armoire to keep them in. Oh, we don't have a dresser. Why don't we have one upstairs? Why didn't I just put it upstairs? I'm a mess. Have you noticed? Oh, there he is. We have to ask him to leave. We were gonna have a baby with him maybe, but we don't have the space, so hey, do I just kick him out? I don't want to do that. He's so nice. I think that's what we have to do. That's so mean. Sorry, I'm so tired and pregnant. This will cause your roommate to move out of the apartment. Yes, I'm so sorry, dude. Clean out this nasty food for our pupper. There was some love hearts. Sorry, love you. He's not taking it hard. I know, baby. Come take a shower first. We'll talk to him later. Maybe we'll meet up with him later and get pregnant anyway. Take a shower and sleep. You are miserably tired. Oh god. I don't even know if that shower is worth it. And hey there. You're tired too. But that's a shame. You gotta go eat some of this cake. We have so much cake. And I don't even know. Oh, look at the pupper. You gotta get your son up. My entire life's purpose is just to make sure that Amelia doesn't die for the next 3 days. Okay, I gotcha. Amelia, I am on you. You guys are all kind of on your own for a bit. Everybody's far too tired for anything that's going on. Cuddle the puppy. Oh my gosh, gosh. Oh my gosh. So cute. Da-da-da-da-da. Oh, she's so much smaller than you. You're just too so cute. That's a bumper. Oh my gosh. That was so precious. Stop sleeping on Max's bed. Put Aiden in that crib. Oh my goodness. What is going on? Mom's like about to die. Actually, no, she's okay. She's not happy, but she's ecstatically happy. Amelia really wants to get a kitten. So we will. She's like hecka dying to get a kitten. I'm actually going to make her go do that first, even though she's dying of hunger. Actually, physically dying of hunger. We're going to get a kitten, too. Ah, just because she wants to, just to make her happier. You should get that smart milk, also. Definitely should get the smart milk for a baby. A little kitten. I would like clean cats. And she wants a kitten. So, genius, independent. You're actually perfectly exactly the same. She's a little cowardly. You know, you bonkers. Bonkers. Join our family, bonkers. Thank you. Alrighty. Kitten acquired. Let's eat up. Our house is disgusting. Why can we not have a clean house for more than 5 minutes? We have a daily maid. Bonkers. Do I want you to name Bonkers? I'm gonna name you Fuzzkins. We gotta bring Bonkers in. Wherever she may be. Where are you, Bonkers? 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 Oh, lost in the snow. That's a Bonkers I know. I mean, Fuzzkins. Bonkers and Max. I mean, Fuzzkins. I should have just left the name as Bonkers. I clearly know nothing. Is that your job? Whose job is that? Who is yelling at me right now? It is your job. Go to work. Sorry that you're starving and everything. I don't know what's going to happen today. It's going to be pretty bad. I like need to hire a nanny to help. My son seems okay though. I'm gonna call for a nanny. I really need to focus on myself. This is like the worst possible time. Imagine if I was doing this by myself. Like, no. I probably wouldn't have a puppy and a kitten. Aw, he's so cute, Aiden. I love your outfit. We need to go buy him actual clothes soon after the baby's born. Go to the nanny. I hate the nannies in this game. I think it's actually the babysitters that I hate. A little kitten really is nothing. We have a little pupper. They're pretty much tapped out on food and everything. Our mail just came. Rent's probably due. Ah, and the maid's here to clean up the thousands of bottles. The nanny's helping her. Oh, we're awake. What did we order? What's going on here? I know I stink. What do you want? Greg is ordered to build a wall near the side of the road near an elderly home. This is due to a complaint that nearby traffic was disturbing the members of the home. As Greg is building in the wall, he notices part of the wall sinking into the ground. The incomplete wall can be seen to be deforming on the soft foundation, leading to an imperfect wall structure. The wall must be complete by the end of the day. Should Greg rebuild part of the sinking wall or add more bricks to it? Rebuild. Greg begins to rebuild the section of the wall that's sinking. Make sure the foundation is sturdy enough before he begins this time. Rebuilding that section of the wall, however, takes the entire rest of the day, and Greg is unable to complete the task that was assigned to him. Furious by his slow progresses, he is demoted. Yike. Okay, I don't know why you're giving me all this attitude, alright? Let's go check the mail, also. Our house is disgusting, and I'm so tired. I just want to have my baby. What is this? Listen to complaint. What complaint? I'm gonna go check the mail. I'm gonna go take a shower. I'm gonna go to bed. You're miserable.
already know. Starvation. Don't check the mail. Don't you dare. You need to come get some leftovers right now. People die in this game from hunger, and I'm not having it. Get some food. I'm not having you die. We didn't get married. She would die. She would probably die. I'm being serious. She and that baby would be killed if you died. We have so much pee. I need to move. As soon as this baby is born, we are moving. There's not enough space here. Like, point blank, period. I don't have space for anything. It's so annoying. Eat your food. Please don't die. Don't fall asleep in it. Eat it. There we go. See, you won't die if you don't have fun. There's gonna be a crazy rabbit here, but that's cool. Thank you, mate. Thank you guys so much for helping me out. The cat and my pupper. Okay, eat both of them so that we're nice and full. How are you doing on eating? You're a little hungry. That's fine. There'll be some spaghetti for eating. Kitty, kitty. I need, like, better beds for everybody. And once again, need to move. But that is for definitely next part. But where am I supposed to put it? I need a second bed as well. But where am I supposed to put it? I don't have space for anything. And it's killing me. I don't have space for anything. I'm gonna put it right here, I guess. No one's gonna be able to use that couch. And we'll go with a little bed or boops. Or I don't even have a litter box. And the kitten can't go upstairs. Everything has to be down here and there's not space. Okay, I'm gonna put this right here. We're gonna move the entire computer upstairs. Because we have so much room in this room and I'm not even using it. Like, why do half these things have to be downstairs? It just needs to be where the baby can go because he can't. Like, half this stuff doesn't need to be downstairs. And it's just downstairs because it looked nice. Right now, we need, like, a functional house. Why can't I pick that up? I just picked it up. Alright, so. Yikes. Okay. This is such a mess. I'm gonna put the litter box in this corner. We're gonna put the food bowl here as well. It's gonna be nasty. But, that's where it's gonna go. And did I need anything of this? Needs to go right here. Be right next to the food bowl, and now we need a second bed. It's far too large. No one's gonna be able to walk over here for any reason. But it'll be okay. Once we move out, everything will be fine. Okay. Max is starving. I just need two bowls because they're like eating the food way too fast. Move out of my way, baby. Woo. I'm gonna fill this bowl as well. I don't even have any toys for the kit. She's gonna tear up my house, like, that's for sure. There's so much pee in my house, you know? I mean, giving him smart milk and not actually teaching him anything isn't really super helpful. But have some smart milk, Aiden. You're such a good baby. This comes from mommy's happiness. And you're so tired. 2 days left? What is happening? What is this? I have no time. What? I can't even make their life longer. I have no time. Dude, he doesn't know how to do anything. He's so dumb. Oh no. Dad, you are... when you wake up tomorrow... 2 days? He just had a birthday in this park. His aspiration meter is... Where is his aspiration meter? He wants to learn how to walk and talk and be potty trained, and those things are not happening right now, apparently. Oh my. I wish the nanny would teach him stuff. Honestly, he's just a glowing smart baby boy. Dad, you're gonna wake up at 7 p.m. Suddenly nighttime, and you are going to teach my son how to use the body, at least. Please, something. Please, anything. Please. Where did that money just go? Is that the nanny? Because I touched my kid. You're leaving? Because that's not fair. I'm gonna potty train you again, okay? And the phone's ringing. I need my wife to sleep. I need her to sleep. But Aiden also doesn't know anything, and he has two parents. Imagine if we didn't have him. Imagine what kind of a disaster this would be. I'm not gonna raise good kids. Are you even learning? Amelia's dead. Are you even learning anything? I'm gonna teach you how to walk instead. Teach him a nursery rhyme as if. Oh, he's so tired. Oh, put him in the crib. We're gonna take this opportunity to sleep. And tomorrow we'll deal with the other issues of our lives. You are not even sleeping. I don't know what's going on here. Did you put him in the crib? I feel like you didn't. Okay. Everybody's in a nice bed. Kitty's not. Well, that's okay. My shower's broken. Oh my god. I wasn't paying attention to your hunger. I died. I'm not going to restart. I'm going to save right now. Age is up in 5 days or whatever it is. 6 days. Like, that's not enough time. I need like 14. How is he supposed to learn anything in 5 days when I'm pregnant and trying not to die? And then dad is like failing at work. Explain how that's supposed to work. And our house is a filthy mess already. The maid literally comes in and our house is twice as disgusting as it was before. Oh, she wants another kitten? I shouldn't have even gotten Fluff first time. Like, I don't even remember his name. Max, that's Max. Fluffkins. Fluff first time. Man, our toilet's broken. At a time, we're gonna have to call that guy. He hates helping us too. He can unclog my toilet and fix our shower that's spewing water everywhere. That means it's just gonna endlessly keep mopping and raking up dollars by the hour. But that's, you know, just me. Potty train, potty train. Fill it up, fill it up, fill it up. You are almost there. Why did you get off? And we need to move so desperately. The second this baby is out, we are moving. Come and grab some. Are all these lunch meat sandwiches bad? My god. We're falling apart. I need to just order Chinese at this point. Honestly and truthfully. I think the nanny is going to be our best resource for the rest of eternity. Especially with so many kids so close together. Just come now. Our house needs to be cleaned up very desperately. I think our pets are okay. As long as they're fed, that's kind of the only thing that we need is for them to be fed. I'm going to pee. I'm going to grab some leftovers. Gonna blow some bubbles. I don't care about their complaints. I don't care. Shut up. They're always complaining. Always. You know, it's fine. We're gonna be moving and it's fine. Where is my maid? Also. Oh, he's here. Hi. Gavin. I need repairs. I need my toilet unclogged. I need everything. Hey, I know you're gonna say that everything looks fine and it doesn't, and you're a liar. It's what you always come and say to me every day. Your apartment looks great. All your toilets are clogged and your shower is spewing water everywhere and your child's sitting in your cereal, but house is perfection. Clean up. Repair my stuff, please. Thank you. There's bottles just strewn everywhere. And my baby kicked off the kit, off the bed. Are you repairing my house or what? My house is falling apart. I'm just trying really hard not to die. Like, okay, thank goodness the maid is here to clean. If we weren't so dirty, I mean, we don't even actually have a garbage can, so who can I blame but myself that we just have bottles everywhere. You know, if we had a garbage can, I mean, the garbage can's just outside, it's probably not even that hard. And you, I'm like having such a hard time. I just want her to have this baby. And Max is starving. Why is Max starving when there's plenty of food options? Max? Yeah. Walk over there and eat. Like, there's food in here as well. Just walk in there and eat. And he's not even that hungry. He's so tired. And she keeps trying to give him bottles. And all he wants to do is go to sleep. And that's why there's so many bottles in my house going bad. But honestly, me too. Okay, thank you, but I'm gonna dismiss you now because you're not helping me. You were putting bottles all over my house. Goodbye. Put Aiden in the crib now. Put him in the crib. I don't care how tired you are. Oh, I know Greg's losing enthusiasm and everything. Isn't everybody? I need my son to go in his crib right now. I don't care about your complaint, okay? I don't care about Greg. I need him to go in his crib because he's so tired. But Let me listen to your complaints. You leave me alone. Everything's smelly. My house is smelly. My life is smelly. I get it. Honestly, I'm traumatized. I don't know how I'm managing not to die right now. We're gonna go to sleep. Oh, this is labor. It's finally over. I thought she was dying. Hooray! Put Brianna in crib and we can move on with our lives. You know what? Don't do it. What is this? Leave Aiden alone. Put Brianna in crib. Oh, why are all these people in my house? Anyway, next part we're gonna be moving. We're gonna be finding daddy number 3 and probably going slower with the pregnancies. I can't right now. I would like them all to grow up well and not garbage. Brianna is probably gonna be our heir, so I need to make sure she's not gonna die. What do you mean our apartment's in great shape? What is this? Is still broken. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this part. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Hopefully it won't fall apart. I hope so. We're doing okay. I love you guys so much. I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.